We're all familiar with the procedure during a police emergency. You dial 999, ask for the Gardaí, and shortly afterwards a squad car arrives at the scene. But what happens in between your call and the response? We've been granted exclusive access to the late shift at the country's largest command and control centre.
When somebody, a person dials 999, they are connected to a central switchboard. The operator will then ask you which service you require, and when the person indicates that it's the Gardaí, he or she will then put you through to the local and closest Garda Control Centre. The Garda Control Centres are all manned by members of the Garda Síochána, who ensure that each call or each request for Garda assistance is dealt with as efficiently and as quickly as possible.
Calling 999 links you to one of four emergency services: police, fire, ambulance or Coast Guard. As the focus of this programme is on crime, we're concentrating on how Gardaí react to policing emergencies around the country. From Dundalk to Donegal, Cork to Carlow, the regional Garda command and control centres take in thousands of calls every month. There are 20 emergency call centres in all, which means that the person receiving the call has local knowledge, important when fast decisions need to be made. The largest centre here in Harcourt Square handles the Dublin metropolitan region.
At this centre we have full responsibility for answering 999 calls and dispatching them to the entire Garda region.
This is the beginning of a typical 8-hour shift in command and control here in Harcourt Square. The intake section records the emergency calls as they come in from the public, while dispatch controls the appropriate response from units on the ground.
Well, the call is first received by one of our call takers.
Garda emergency.
And they will create an instant on the computer-aided dispatch system.
Yes. And what's the nature of your complaint?
They'll assess the call and then they'll use one of the types of the system to describe the call. The call goes into the system then and it goes to one of our divisional radio dispatchers. And he or she will read the contents of the call and give it to one of our mobiles.
Control for Alpha Charlie 2.
The mobile units are in constant liaison with command and control, ensuring efficient response times on the ground.
Kilmainham Garda Station is a sub-district station of Kelvin Street, and we're known as Alpha Charlie. Alpha Charlie Base would be Kilmainham, and Alpha Bravo Base would be Kelvin Street.
I would expect to receive a good mix of public complaints, public order issue calls, alarm activations, including intruder and alarm activations and personal attack alarms, a good deal of activity reports as suspicious, and of course traffic-related matters.
Yes, and what block of Michael's estate? Yes, can you give me a description of the two individuals?
Control for Alpha Charlie 2.
Alpha Charlie 2 to control.
Basically, I would take in calls on the 999 line here. I would input them into the computer. I would get as much information as possible and categorise them. And every category would have a different priority, although depending if there was a weapon being used in the call, you may have to change the priority. People can get quite stressed because the nature of it is that it is an emergency. So the first thing I would say to them if I feel I'm not getting the information is to take a deep breath, try and relax. People often forget to give you the main points of information that we would need in order to decide what response we need to provide to the call.
Prioritising resources is a major responsibility. Once the 999 call comes in, the information is sent on to dispatch, where a decision on the response must be made and time is critical.
Well, in the dispatch, the main difference is the fact that at the other end of the line here is guards, not the public. I have to give them the information they require to go to the call, where it is, what is happening, or what they're going to come across. Or as much as I know, I have to give them that information.
Alpha Charlie 2 to control.
There's two main ways to prioritise calls. The first is if the call is active at that time, if there's something happening.
This guy had this implement, it seems to be a fork, he had it in his pocket, but he hasn't actually threatened anyone with it. He's discarded it here on the ground.
Also then, the severity of the call. If it's a material damage accident, as opposed to a personal injury accident, that again is taken into consideration when we're sending out a car to the call.
Abusive and threatening to the staff in there. So they don't want you to stay here, they want you to leave the premises.
No, but I'll leave.
All right. An intoxicated male there removed from the premises.
informing the appropriate response to an emergency call can be informed by the visual information processed in the traffic control centre. This section of the command and control centre monitors over 250 live cameras and liaises with the emergency calls database.
What we have here is a full-time dedicated traffic control centre, and it's for the Greater Dublin region. Where we manage the resources and any incidents and traffic management and enforcement around the city. We have access to about 250 cameras from various agencies. We have the main screens here will show you Dublin City Council's cameras. We also have cameras that cover every inch of the Lewis line, and we have our own Garda cameras. If we have a serious incident or a major incident, we have an overall view, command and control view sort of what's happening there to assist the units on the ground to tell them the overall big picture. We deal closely on a daily basis with the other agencies involved, be it the local authorities, Dublin City Council in particular, obviously being at the city centre. Whereas before we had all these agencies operating independently, and to get something done and communicating between, we now found that having pulled them all together, it works much better, much tighter, response times are better, things have improved dealing with incidents and the systems. We don't take any 99 calls here. They're dealt with outside on the main system, and then if they're traffic related, they come into us.
Alpha Charlie 2 control, in pursuit of a white Nissan Micra.
Working here is very high pressure, especially during our busier periods. It's difficult and challenging at times to maintain your professional calm.
A combination of experience, organisation and technology has meant that the response time to 999 calls in the Dublin metropolitan area in the current year averages just 8 minutes.
Yeah, I've been here 4 years now, and I think it gets easier, and I believe that I make better decisions the longer I'm here. Same for a lot of the guards that work here.
The command and control centres nationwide work together with locally based mobile units to deal with all emergency calls.
Ideally, the 999 service should only be used when an emergency exists or an immediate Garda response is required. Example, a threat to life, a serious crime has been committed, a serious public order offences occurring, or serious damage to property. However, all calls received on the 999 system are dealt with in accordance with priority.
Alright, resident of 107, the Royal Traffic Act, alright? Verify your name and address. Do you understand that? Oh, hold on now.
Your driver has no insurance details, no driving license with him, nothing with a name and address or anything on it. He's arrested under section 107, the Royal Traffic Act, to verify his name and address. The car has been seized under section 41, the Royal Traffic Act, for having no insurance.
Just sit this side. Another car coming to take prisoner.
We all hope we never have to dial the 999 emergency number, but it is reassuring to know that if we do have to call, a dedicated support service is ready to respond.